The biggest success stories for textile to textile recycling have been either in the business to business workwear industry or in the denim industry. So if you look at those two streams and kind of analyze what do they have in common, they are very easily identifiable. If you have a mass of post-consumer textiles, you can easily see your denim and pull it out. It has a, you know, a uniform color. It's going to be indigo blue usually. And it has a, usually a uniform fiber composition. You can be fairly certain that it's going to be a high quality of, you know, high cotton content, maybe with 2% spandex, but usually 100% cotton. And therein lies kind of the clue, because what people don't talk about is that you need to know the fiber composition of the textiles that you're recycling, that certain technologies can process certain fiber compositions. So without knowing, you can't get that ball rolling. And a system for that doesn't exist yet.
So what you're saying is that one of the main barriers to get these new recycling technologies going is that we have difficulty sorting the right kinds of fiber, right?
Exactly, sorting on fiber compositions, okay. Yeah. At the scale that we need, with the accuracy that we need. And this has been one of the main kind of driving projects of the textiles program the past year, around a piece of technology called the fiber sort, which will hopefully be the, you know, commercially scalable solution to sorting by fiber composition. So you will get an input of, you know, a mixed bag of recyclable grade textiles, and it will be programmed, for instance, to detect 100% cotton, 100% polyester, 100% wool, for example. As the textiles go through, this is detected and communicated to the machine, which blows it off at different points. So you'll get those separate sorted streams, which are then perfect for recycling. You know, why it's really interesting is not only because it's going to, yes, provide textile recyclers with really high volume, high quality, you know, controlled feedstock, which is going to increase their yield, but also in, you know, increase the level and the quality of their output, because input equals output. But also for the sorters and, you know, that side of things, it will also revolutionize their business, because at the moment the low-grade textiles, all the textiles that aren't good enough to be resold as reuse, are deemed recyclable, and they are, you know, they're a bleeder for the industry, because either they're being sold at a pittance, absolutely nothing, to the downcycling industry, or in a lot of cases the sorter is actually paying for it to be incinerated or landfilled. So the reuse is subsidizing the recyclable grade at the moment. And because we have a fast fashion industry with really low quality clothing, that recyclable grade is getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and the reuse is getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So their business model is under serious pressure. Something like the fiber sort could add, you know, a value-adding step. It could give value to this recyclable grade and bring in increased revenue for these sorters, who are now under a lot of pressure.